Hey, you guys, welcome back to Married to Film. Listen, here's part two.
Your Russian is getting better. Come on, what is it? I bring news from America.
I heard from your friends.
They're bringing you money to Alaska.
When?
Today, I hope. If my pilot gets the money, he will bring it to me in his plane tomorrow. Then you can hitch a ride with him back to your country. I get rich, and you're a free man. Sounds too good to be true, yes?
It does. This pilot you found, are you sure you can trust him?
His name is Yuri Ismailov. He's a smuggler. Supplies American goods to some of his guards here, including me on lucky occasions. Cigarettes, peanut butter, Playboys.
Playboys.
Best America can store for.
Right, choose a criminal.
Of course. Who else do you want to do this job, Gandhi?
Right.
I can tell him.
He's not a lot, but he
when
didn't.
I talk to her, I can tell by voice that she's very pretty, feisty too. I like that.
Watch out.
Shame we won't meet. You promised me that she will be safe. And she will be. Let me handle Yuri. You have more important things to worry about. Remember, you miss that plane tomorrow. I am still rich. You are still stuck in Kamchatka. So whatever it is you're planning, America, let's get to it, yes? Where do you want it?
Punch!
So you're saying that this thing that killed Fred and Chrissy, it's from the Upside Down?
That's the true sense. Our working theory is that he attacks with a spell or a curse. Now whether or not he's doing the bidding with a mind flayer or just loves killing teens, we don't know.
All we know is that this is something different, something new. Doesn't make sense.
It's only a theory.
No, Fred and Chrissy don't make sense.
What did you tell the little boy before you killed him?
Why them?
Maybe they were just in the wrong place. They were both at the game.
And near the trailer park.
We're at the trailer park.
Right.
Should we maybe not be here?
Right.
Max said Chrissy was upset too.
Yeah, but not here. She was crying in the bathroom at school. Serial killers stalk their prey before they strike, right? So maybe Fred and Chrissy saw this Vec man.
Vec, no.
I don't know about you guys, but if I saw some freaking wizard monster, I would mention it to someone.
Maybe they did. I saw Chrissy leaving Miss Kelly's office.
Yeah.
If you saw a monster, you wouldn't go to the police. They'd never believe you.
Yeah.
But you might go to your
shrink.
Uncle, don't go back in that house ever again.
What?
I'm glad y'all got out of there.
Oh, that's where he is! Upside down!
Professor Xavier Palmer, he's got
cerebral. Gross. Well, what do we have here?
And that's when you struck her.
I'm gonna need you to give me a verbal response.
No!
Yes. But that is when I hit her.
And why did you hit her?
I don't know.
You don't know? You know the girl you hit? She had a grade 2 concussion. Did you know that?
Did you want to kill her?
I don't know.
You didn't know if you wanted to kill her.
You should have a lawyer present.
No.
No, you didn't want to kill her. No, you don't know.
I don't know.
Jane Hopper. Okay, yes, I see her now. It looks like she's still being processed.
Okay, so, what does that mean exactly?
It means they're putting her in the system, after which point she'll be transferred to juvenile hall.
What?
You just went in front of the van!
Right.
Shit.
uncle, Wayne, thinks that Victor Creel escaped from Penrith Asylum and that he's the one running around Hawkins committing all these murders? Pretty much. But
she just looks hot
Victor
to me.
Committed the eyeball murders, like, way back in the 50s. 59. So, that means these murders predate 11 and the Upside Down by about 30 years?
Yeah.
Which makes spooky Victor Creel, like, 70 years old.
Yep.
Mads, hi.
Hi. I'm so sorry to bother you for a break, but do you have a minute to talk?
Yeah. Of course.
That's the counselor.
Okay, she's in.
A missing collarbones, not eyes. We gonna talk about it?
Sorry, talk about what?
Your temporary insanity earlier today when you basically threw yourself at Nance.
Okay, first of all, that's not what happened.
Pretty sure
that's
what happened. It was pretty public. There were like a lot of witnesses.
Are you implying that's the thing for Nance?
No, I'm not implying. I'm stating, and as it relates to your steadfast refusal to date Robin, it's pretty much the only logical explanation.
That's not the only one. And as for Nance, I was just trying to protect a friend. A friend, Henderson, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna find her in the morning with her eyes sucked out of the front of her skull by this Vecna creep.
You're like bright red in your face right
now. No, I'm not. I don't want to talk about it. I'll punch
what?
You so hard in your face that your teeth will fall back out.
Oh. Too far.
Too far. Not cool. Sorry.
With everything that's happening, with all the murders, it's making everything worse again.
You've experienced trauma, Max. And when you keep your feelings, your pain, bottled up the way you do, it doesn't take much to trigger them again. So now when it rains, it storms. Are you ready to talk more about that night?
Heck no, when her brother died. What if it's Billy?
I live next door to where it happened. I'm sorry?
I doubt it, but that'd be cool.
Chrissy was murdered. Cops
they ain't killing people?
Questions.
Not that they ain't killed Billy.
Did they talk to you?
But you see the way he sucked?
I know you were seeing Chrissy.
Max, you know I can't talk about Chrissy or any other student.
Can I use the bathroom?
Sure. Up the stairs to the left.
So she's going in the bowl? She's going in the bowl.
Get the keys, the file cabinet keys, probably at the office, yeah. Go, go!
What'd she say?
Nothing, I just drive.
Nothing.
Steve, drive!
And I know it's home.
So now what? We keep looking. The town's not that big. Only so many places these freaks can burrow. Where the hell is Sinclair?
Where the hell have you been?
Just listen. Are you guys looking for Eddie?
Yeah. We found him, no thanks to you.
You found him?
He's at a boathouse on Coal Mill Road. Don't worry, he's safe.
You guys know he killed Chrissy, right?
That's bullshit. Eddie tried to save Chrissy.
Then why do all the cops say he didn't?
Lucas, you're so behind, it's ridiculous, okay? Just meet us at the school. We'll explain later.
I can't. I think some real bad shit's about to go down.
What are you talking about? What bad shit?
Uh-oh.
Sinclair!
What the hell were you doing?
I was looking for clues.
Clues? Well, at first you think Sherlock Holmes is home?
I found one. I know where Eddie's hiding.
He better not take him out there.
I'm not gonna do it.
Girl, it's Area 51. I'm coming to get you!
Jane Hopper?
Yeah, what is this?
I'll take her off your hands.
Ah! Run!
Oh, girl.
No!
Oh.
Cool.